you know, first of all, we weren't sure whether we were going to get a game at all after watching last night's game. We were pretty, I guess, apprehensive about what was possible from the Spirits coach side. When the way they came out and had it, I thought was incredibly brave, incredibly free and turf their mind, and they certainly came hard at us. Put us under a huge amount of pressure. At halftime, boys were pretty nervous, but we managed to, I guess, show the skills we've got with the bat, show that we do have some power hitters on our team, and managed to get across the line. My frustration was probably more about the fact that we're dealing up to the beginning of the end to make sure that we won the game. But in the end, the way Roscoe finished it off, couldn't be happier, I think. Those sorts of things happen, and I guess that's part of the rest of the game. Well, yeah, Dan slipped over his training and injured his shoulder. He had a injection on this morning, but it still felt a bit of pain. So hopefully with a couple of days, it's all well. So the 36 hours to our next game, hopefully he'll be right for that. If not, then we've got to get out here around ways we can operate without him in that game against Peru, South African side. But we're all fingers crossed that we get such an important player and our captain down back for the next game and for the duration of the tour. Yeah, I guess today we're firm favourites to win the game. When the game gets reduced to 7 overs a side, you start to, I guess, the legend becomes a little bit more balanced. But I guess we're still very much expecting to win this game, and we're very much expecting ourselves to win this game. We managed to get across the line. In terms of the rest of the tournament, how we perceive ourselves in terms of what we're trying to achieve, we believe we can win it. There's no point in us being here if we don't believe that we can win it. We believe we've got some exciting players who are capable of turning games on their head. And if we can concentrate on what we have to do in each game and in each situation, there's no reason why we can't be there come final time. Yes, the way other people perceive us, it's out of our control. We've been playing some good cricket for a while, and I think we're a dangerous outfit in terms of 2020. That game last night, and it wasn't a game where one team got lucky. Everyone's got lucky. It was nothing to do with that. They had to score 160 runs against one of them. So I thought the way they played shows in this form of the game, the shorter version of the game, if you're prepared to be brave enough, prepared to play with that freedom, if you get a bit of luck out of your way, then you can upset your teams. And I think the justification of those guys in the tournament was shown not only last night but also today. And I guess England now probably a little bit under pressure, but they've still got some fight left in them, I'm sure. If they get their confidence back in the next game, I'm sure they'll play well.
More than confident, that's the, you know, somebody said to me, somebody said to me this morning, we're going to come here and I'll feel this bad about not beating New Zealand, you know, they'll probably snap their hand off, but the reality of the whole thing is it, you know, I've said, since we started, listen, we've got to identify moments when we've got to take games, and they're never going to come, they're few and far between, and when they come, we've got to take them, and we just simply didn't do it today. Well, first half of the game, we just performed out of our skin, and then we've been putting these thoughts into batters, and we've been having game plans of how we're going to do it, and the batters put it 100% into it today. But in recent years, I mean, we've been very guilty of not getting all three disciplines together, and if there was another day to do it, today was it. And that's obviously just like I said, identifying those moments, and when they come, we've really got to take them rather than just walking off the field and just saying the same things day after day after and saying what if, which is getting frustrating to say the least. But we had a chat, I had a chat to the bowlers had a chat, we decided what's going to be the best game plan here, and I was very happy with it, all the bowlers were very happy with it, but you know, I'm sure by the one ambition when we had a chat about it, the execution was absolutely no idea. But saying that in the field, we prided ourselves on where we've been fielding in recent weeks, and today it just simply was not good enough. I mean, we've got to take catches, we've got to stop boundaries. We can't see an international team getting out of the way of the ball, it's going to be fast, too fast, it's just absolutely ridiculous. So, like I said, I'm not going to sit here and criticise the ball because it was, I never thought the effort, I never will. It's a bit of disappointment, it's just nothing short of disappointment because, you know, it's just something we've been aiming for, and we gave ourselves more than a good chance to do it today, and, you know, it's just a matter. Oh, goodness me, halfway, I think we're well hot favourites to win it. I mean, there's no beating on the bush week. we were backing ourselves in a big way. I was very confident in terms of what, I mean, our bowlers are exceptional at bowling at the death, the bowlers you selected. Yeah, and like I said, we had a game plan, it was just a matter of sticking to it. But yeah, I mean, I was more than confident, and I was very, very happy with the position we're in. Yeah, so I mean, in terms of the winning, which soon became a reality, obviously, and taken away from us.